So we talked to Neera Yal about vitamins versus painkillers. And I wanted to ask you the same question. What do you think is better for an entrepreneur when he thinks about types of ideas, vitamins or painkillers?
It's funny, I don't really think about it in those terms, but I guess the way I think about it is kind of the same way. I would say the painkiller is a much bigger deal. But even more than the painkiller, I think you want like a life-saving drug.
Right.
You want something that someone really, really needs. My partner, Paul Buhait, said, way better to build something that a few people love than a lot of people sort of like.
Right.
And so that's what we look for. It's something that people really, really want, because those are going to be your initial core of passionate users who are going to engage with you sufficiently to help you develop your product and make it better. If you just have something that people kind of like, meh, they'll use it a couple times and then they'll go away. And if your initial users just go away, you're left with a ghost town.
Right.
I think that the biggest challenge for startups, you know, people talk about, you know, you're going to run out of money, you're going to this and that. I think the biggest problems that most startups have, you run out of time. And part of the reason you run out of time is because you're fighting the apathy of the market. It's not that people know about you and don't like you. It's that no one has any idea who you are. And if you solve something that's a really deep pain for someone, they're going to talk about you. So forget all the conversation about, you know, viral marketing, this kind of marketing, that kind of marketing, these tactics. If you solve something really important to someone, they're going to mention it.
Can you give me an example of a vitamin and a painkiller?
Yeah, I think that, you know, again, it's this idea of it's different things for different people. I think Stripe's a pretty good example of a painkiller. Integrating payments into a website is such a big pain in the butt without something like Stripe. I remember when we integrated PayPal, it took days and weeks just to like, and they didn't even have developer documents that you could read in any kind of way.
Right.
And it took weeks and to get this and the, that and the other thing. It was a nightmare. Stripe's a couple lines of code and you have payments set up. And you know, for some people, if you're not building a website, that seems like a vitamin. It seems like a nice to have. But in terms of supportability and deployment, like all these things and ease of use, that's a huge painkiller for anyone building something for e-commerce, honestly.
Very cool.
In terms of vitamins, I don't know. There's kind of a lot of them. Not to say, and some of them are probably really successful companies or become successful over time, but I think that they don't scale quite as quickly. You know, an incremental hairdresser closer to your house,
right?
You know, 5 miles closer is a vitamin.
Right.
You could drive another 5 miles. When it comes to software, I don't know, there are a lot of things out there. If you look at the app charts, you probably see a lot of them.